I don't know about you, but I sure am sick of things happening. Every time I pick up my phone, the New York Times tells me that a thing happened, and I'm like, well, I guess I gotta get drunk. And then the next day something else happens, and I'm like, okay, so it's time to get drunk again. And now it's 24 years later, and I'm an alcoholic. But that's just a fact of life. Things happen every day, no matter how hungover you are. As an example, here's a list of some of the things that happened yesterday, which I'm gonna have my editors put in at the last minute because I wrote the script a week ago. Wow, look at all those things that happened. I sure hope I actually made my point. Anyway, this convoluted introduction got me thinking. What was the day when the fewest things happened? Or, in other words, what was the most boring day in human history? And it turns out there is actually some consensus that that day is probably April 11th, 1954. Why? Well, let me explain. That day was calculated a few years back by a British computer scientist named William Tunstall Pideaux. You see, Tunstall Pideaux had developed a software called True Knowledge, which was essentially just a massive database of discrete, crowd-based facts that is now known as Jeff Bezos' girlfriend, Alexa, but before its acquisition by Amazon, it was an independent database that was used to understand and answer simple questions. Things like, when is Bono's birthday? Or, how old is Bono turning this year? Or, why didn't Bono invite me to his 62nd birthday party? Did he just forget, or is he mad at me? Now, some of the facts in True Knowledge's database took the form of general rules that helped it understand what a question was asking, like birthday is a subtype of creation date, but the vast majority of facts were more specific, like Bono was created on May 10th, 1960. So, seeing as a big chunk of the 300 million facts in his database were essentially just dates when things happened, Tunstall Pideaux wondered what day, since January 1st, 1900, had the least number of facts associated with it. Conflicts, elections, major accidents, notable performances, famous births, famous deaths, you get the idea. And just as a side note, yeah, he restricted the timeline to the last two centuries because the real most boring day in human history was probably some day 60,000 years ago when the most exciting thing that could happen was finding a berry on the ground, but that's a boring answer, and not boring in the interesting way. Now, as you might have already guessed, the date that showed up the least was April 11th, 1954. But that doesn't mean that nothing happened that day. A few things did. So, because we're a beacon of journalistic integrity, I had my writers scour the internet, encyclopedias, and newspaper archives to put together the most comprehensive description of the most boring day in human history. Probably the most important thing that happened that day anywhere in the world was the 1954 Belgium general election. And I know I can already hear my Belgian viewers saying, hey, what the hell? Are you saying our elections are boring? That makes me so angry that I'm gonna eat a yeast-based waffle. But look, this wasn't a particularly eventful election, even for Belgium. The Christian Social Party lost a couple of seats in parliament, and this man was elected prime minister, who went on to enact some modest labor laws and have a Wikipedia page that's shorter than the Wikipedia page for lint. But besides that, not a lot happened. The very last Coppa della Toscana happened in Tuscany, golfer Marlene Haig won the 1954 New Orleans Women's Open, the 52nd Paris-Roubaix bike race happened in France, the 1954 All-Ireland Senior Hurling Championship opened in Dublin, and it's possible that a non-lethal coup d'etat was planned that night in the French-occupied territory of Yanayan, India, but it didn't actually happen until 2 days later, so it's kind of hard to count that. If we can count things that were planned as things that actually happened, then we might as well say that I actually have a daytime talk show where I read fun facts about planes to hot celebrities. But surely, somewhere in the world, someone important must have been born or died that day, right? Well, not really. The most important person I could find who was born on April 11th, 1954 is this guy, Ian F. Akyildiz. He's a Turkish electrical engineer who wrote some textbooks, I guess? And he helped design some cellular networks and founded a company whose website, ironically, does not work. But that's it. That's the most important guy. Of the 250,000 or so babies born that day, none of them have written better networking textbooks or have patented more routing schemes. As for famous deaths, I really had to scrape the bottom of the corpse barrel and came up with this guy, Paul Specht. He was a decently popular American bandleader from the 1920s, whose personal history is seemingly only recorded in this terrifying website from 2006. Yes, I read the whole thing, and no, none of it was interesting. I'm not even sure if any of it is accurate because, well, like, look at the website. So, now that I have hopefully established beyond a shadow of a doubt that April 11th, 1954 was the most boring day in recent human history, this raises the pretty obvious follow-up question of, then, what was the most eventful day in human history? But that, unfortunately, is a lot harder to answer because it's probably not just the day with the most total events. After all, events are not all created equal. Like, Paris Hilton and Joseph Gordon-Levitt might have been born on the same day, but even with their total star power combined, they probably don't equal one Cuban Missile Crisis. You would need to give birth to, like, 50 Joseph Gordon-Levitts to reach one Cuban Missile Crisis. That's just plain math. What's never the most boring day in history for me, though, is any day that I use HelloFresh. That's because HelloFresh is a meal kit service where you select what you want to eat 1 week, and then the next, a box shows up at your door with all the ingredients you need in the exact quantities you need, along with recipes, for a huge variety of meals that you would have never thought to make by yourself. Beyond the variety, there's also the convenience. Through cutting out shopping time and much of the prep work, you can make home-cooked meals quicker, and they're delicious, too. All around, I find HelloFresh to be a faster, more interesting, affordable way to eat without resorting to expensive takeout or unhealthy frozen food, and that's why I've been using them to make meals like this crispy buffalo spice chicken for almost 2 years, long before they started sponsoring the channel. So if you want to improve dinner time too, click the button on screen or go to HelloFresh.com and use code HI16 for up to 16 free meals and 3 surprise gifts.